Hey guys, Peru here to do an album review. Today I'm here to tell you about the latest from Wormwood, Archivette, out August 27th on Black Lodge Records. This album has 7 tracks, 47 minutes in length, and this is the band's third full-length studio album. They are a Swedish black metal band. Now, this is a concept record. It has a theme. The theme is mankind's failure to take care of our very own planet, and then how the planet responds to that by treating us as an illness, as a virus, pushing us towards extinction. I really like this concept. It feels very modern, it feels very current, and because of that, it really hit home with me and I was hooked to it from the get-go. Now the question is, how do you translate this theme, this concept, into a structure, into a soundscape? Well, as far as the structure goes, this album is perfect. It feels very simple. Not to say that the album is simple, but the structure of the record offers this linear path that you take from the first song all the way to the last song. The tracks are intertwined with one another. They really coexist well. They don't break. There's no pauses between songs. There's always this sense of movement. There's this sense of journey, uninterrupted journey from the first to the last track, allowing you to stay connected with the record. Never really walk away from it because you want to enjoy every single minute of every single song and you want to see what the next track is going to have in store. So from a structural perspective, tying into the theme, tying into the concept, this album moves in a perfect manner, is constructed in a perfect manner, in a way that really brings you in into its bubble and it keeps you there for the duration of the length of the album. Once you get into the soundscape, this album brings a lot of elements of the two previous records. There's a lot of melodic black metal influences, there's a lot of darkness, but at the same time a lot of melody that comes into the forefront and really becomes the soundscape of the record itself. So they didn't go completely outside the box on this album, they just continue to work on what they had done before with the two previous records, and I felt like they just added some extra elements. There's some folk elements on this album, not that we hadn't seen that before, but they were presented in a different manner on this record that really made the overall experience a little bit richer, a little bit thicker, a little bit more robust. I feel like overall, from a soundscape perspective, this album has a lot more to give, has a lot more to digest from a listener's perspective. There's a lot more things for you to break down in order for you to really grasp how grandiose the sound is on this record from song to song. And that sound really takes you into the atmosphere of the track, into what the lyrical content of the track is. I don't think you can break the lyrical content, the atmosphere, and the soundscape apart. All three elements are coming together in order for each song to really drive home the experience, the message that it has. So from that perspective, the album has a lot to give. Like I said, a much richer and robust record than the two previous albums, but still keeping a lot, I would say most of the DNA of the band coming from those two albums into this album, absolutely intact, just morphing, just growing, just giving you a little bit more to process on this record, which was needed considering the theme, considering the concept of the album. So you really had to go a little bit beyond what you had done before. You had to go a little bit deeper within you. The album has to be a little bit more organic. It has to feel a little bit more personal. And I think because of the current status of the world and the world that we currently live in, talking about a theme like this, talking about a topic like this really hits home. And because of that, it's undeniable that you bring in a lot of your own fears, a lot of your own baggage, a lot of your own emotions into the forefront when you're constructing the album. And that is definitely present in the soundscape and the atmosphere that this record creates. Within that sound, you have to talk about the drums, you have to talk about the guitars. I love the drums on this album because they always set the tempo. They're always there to really set the mood, the movement that this record has. The pauses that the songs have, the ebbs and flows of the tracks are really given most often by the drums and how they sound and how they consistent they are. On the other hand, you have the guitars creating a little bit more atmosphere, being a little bit more driven, a little bit more penetrating, and adding a lot of melody to the overall experience. But that melody has also a lot of darkness. They're able to combine the two. When you listen to this record, there are certain parts of the album, there are certain songs that will give you goosebumps because you can't really discern the difference between the melody that it has, the beauty that it holds, and also the darkness, the death that comes with it. The two are just one, and because they're one, it's really hard for you to process them, and you feel like you're somewhere in between. So I love the guitar sound on this record. I love how it drives the album. I love how it drives the atmosphere of the album, while the drums are perhaps the motor of the record. But the two are really working well as one throughout the album to give you that robust sound, that rich effect that I mentioned earlier when you look at the overall soundscape. On top of it, you have the vocals. The vocals on this record are really important because of the theme and because of the lyrical content. You have to be able to bring the darkness, the aggression, the pain, the suffering that it's present there in the stories that you're telling into the forefront. And I felt that overall vocally, that was definitely achieved. The other element that I really enjoyed on this record is a little bit of the narrator pieces that are within the album. I think it helps you guide your experience. It helps you understand exactly where you are within the path towards destruction. I thought it added flavor, it added flair. It really gave the album a little bit extra life, a little bit of an extra push, and it took away perhaps the flatline monotony of having the same style vocals from the first song all the way to the last. It were used sporadically throughout the record, but it really helped change the eyesight of the listener as you move across and not feel necessarily that everything that you're getting vocally is just one flat line from top to bottom. Because musically, the album, and even from an atmosphere perspective, this album really goes to a lot of different places. It moves from light into darkness, back into light, back into darkness. There's a lot of ebbs and flows. So you need to give something to the vocals to kind of match, not necessarily be as robust, as dynamic as the sound is, but match a little bit of that intensity, of that drive, of that storytelling aspect. And I thought they did perfectly on that front by including some narrator style pieces here and there in order to bring the song together. Also bringing some atmospheric sounds of nature was important to bring the lyrics to the forefront, to bring the concept to the forefront, to really give life to these songs. Overall, I really enjoyed this record. It's hard to say that this is perhaps not their best album to date. It just feels more mature, feels more put together, really well crafted from thought process, from concept into execution. The structure of this album is perhaps the best structure as far as an album is concerned that they've ever done, in terms of really giving you this sense of continuity, perfect fluidity. It's like a river. From the time you start until you finish, it just keeps moving you forward. So I really love this record from a construction perspective, from a soundscape perspective, from a themes perspective, but at the end it feels a little bit unfinished. It feels open-ended. I know they tried to close off the record with the last track of the album. There is a sense of closure, there's a sense of coming full circle, if you will, but to me it wasn't enough. This is an album that from a spiritual perspective, from an emotional drive perspective, it really feels open-ended. It feels like there's still a chapter to be told. There's still something at the end, or at least as a listener, I'm hoping that there is something towards the end, and it wasn't there. So perhaps having an outro, an instrumental outro, would help bring this record together. I think would give a sense of a completion to the album. But outside of that, this is one of their best, if not their best record to date. I just feel like it's a very mature approach. It's just missing that closure at the end, that curtain call at the end, to really make things feel a little bit more complete. As far as favorite tracks are concerned, I want to start off with Overgrowth. This is my favorite track on the album. It's the second song on the record. I love the melody that this song has. It's both beautiful and haunting. It just has this mixture of both feelings. You never really know if you're enjoying the beauty of the song or if you're captivated by the darkness that it has. It just has this sort of mixture, this sort of mist that really comes across. The drums push the song and then the guitars create the atmosphere. That is the combo that you're going to get throughout this track. The combination really allows the song to be robust, to be big, to feel a little bit thicker. The vocals become the life of the song. They bring the song to life. They bring the lyrics into the forefront. And then there's an atmospheric bridge that leads into the guitar solo, and the solo keeps the main riff, the main melody, and the backdrop. That combination, that stretch of going from that atmospheric bridge into the guitar solo, keeping the main portion, the main heartbeat of the song alive behind the solo, is just magnificent. It really completes the track. It brings everything together, and it really brings the song into the forefront as being one of the best, more complete tracks on this record. Next, you have In Message. I really love this song as well because of the powerful drums that it has. The guitars kind of lay the roadmap, but the drums are the motor that push you through it. It has darkness, it has melody, a track that has ebbs and flows, peaks and valleys, that moves really well, both with the sound that it has and the atmosphere that it creates, allowing you to bring aggression into the forefront and then bringing some more introspective, melancholic moments as well. So it's a very dynamic track that really has a lot of ups and downs, and because of that, becomes very engaging for the listener. Last but not least, The Slow Drown. slow burning song. It finishes almost as it starts. It doesn't go completely full circle, but there's a sense of tying in both ends together. In between, it's a track that moves at start under the waves. It feels like it's coming from underneath the surface and then is slowly, gradually moving towards the top. It's a track that feels like it's always evolving, it's always growing, it's always morphing, both musically and vocally. It doesn't stay linear. It just feels like it's adding pieces. It's becoming bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger as you progress through it. And then there's a sense of going towards the finish line and everything kind of dissipating and going down the drain, if you will. There's a sense of drain out at the end of the track that brings that ending very close to how the song started, that brewing at the beginning. Because with the start of life, in the end of life, there's a sense of commonality, and I really feel like this song ties in that start of life and end of life perfectly well. In between, you have growth, you grow as an individual, you grow as a person, plants, trees, everything. There's a sense of growth that really is well represented as far as nature is concerned within the song itself. But at the end, you always gonna end up going back to where you started. So from death comes life, and this song is really the pure representation of that musically and vocally. This is it. This is it. Wormwood with Arcavet out August 27th on Black Lodge Records. Let me know your thoughts on the band, on the singles. Use the comment section below. I'll be reading those and getting back to you. Take care, guys.